And the war cry focus is titled this morning, Traumatic Experiences Are Real. Sit, chill, and heal. I'm going to say that one more time because that's a mouthful. Traumatic experiences are real. Sit, chill, and heal. Before we go to the Word of God this morning, let me say this. Many of our life's traumatic experiences we have suppressed, not addressed. Healing is a process. Gradual progress, course as the process of war. Heal, to restore to soundness, to purify from corruption. Redress grievances, and to restore to prosperity. Here are four key strategies to the process of healing. Number one, feel it all. When waves of anger or guilt or resentment pop up, it's easy to resist them. We judge ourselves for having painful or ugly emotions, and it's often hard to separate the emotion from the thought. But give yourself time to feel, no matter how long it takes. Feelings and thoughts are connected, but separate. Try to feel without gripping the thoughts as they flow through. This becomes easier with practice, and over time, you'll be able to purposefully investigate feelings, thoughts at separate times. As the more intense feelings dissipate, you can begin the latter, more objective work, first soul, then mind. Number two, go at your own pace. The process can be especially difficult when we feel anger or another emotion, and it goes away only to return. You may castigate yourself. I thought this was over. It's so important to honor the process and have faith in your wholeness. Keep feeling the emotions. If you resist them, you stall the process of healing. Sometimes we give ourselves timetables and become upset or doubt ourselves when the process takes longer than we want. Have faith in the process and let your spirit guide the way. The spirit knows exactly how to heal, kind of like how the body knows how to heal an injury, muscle, without intervention. The important thing is to silence the mind's judgment. Not silence the mind completely, because the mind is an important tool to help us better understand the psyche. Have faith in your ability to heal. Have faith that you are whole and this experience will pass. Number three, sleep and or move mindfully. Maybe you need sleep 10 hours a night for a week, and that's part of healing. A lot of processing happens during sleep. And if that's what your body wants, try to find the time. Or maybe you need to run 5 miles or go to kickboxing class to release anger. Whatever the energy of the situation calls for, try to tune into your inner self and give yourself what you need. Have faith that your energy will return or your anger will evaporate when the energy body has processed what it needs to process. And number four, lastly, look for the root. Is this a recurring pattern? What is the root? Look deeply and honestly, perhaps going way back to your childhood. I resented this for a long time, but recently I have been able to attribute a long-standing difficulty in my life to things that happened when I was younger. It's good to take responsibility for your actions, but at some point you have to sit back and ask yourself, where is all of this coming from? As you dig into your psyche, difficult feelings may arise, maybe anger or resistance. This is a signal you are on to something. Hold the feeling in awareness as you trigger different places in your energetic body. You can hold the resulting emotions in awareness and heal increasingly deeper parts of yourself. As you heal energetically, these patterns will come undone, healing soul and mind. It will then take awareness in the future to develop and maintain new patterns. This is how you can use emotions to dig deeper into your thoughts and your thoughts to investigate more deeply into your emotions. Traumatic experiences are real. Sit, chill, and heal. The Word of God reads today in Isaiah 57, verses 15 through 19. And I'm reading in the New King James Version. For this says the High and Lofty One, who inhabits eternity, whose name is holy. I dwell in the high and holy place with him who has a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the humble and to revive the heart of the contrite ones. For I will not contend forever, nor will I always be angry, for the spirit will fall before me and the souls which I have made. For the integrity of his covetousness, I was angry and struck him. I hid and was angry, and he went on backsliding in the way of his heart. I have seen his ways and will heal him. I will also lead him and restore comfort to him and to his mourners. I create the fruit of the lips, peace, peace to him who is far off and to him who is near, says the Lord, and I will heal him. Dear gracious and eternal Father, we thank you this morning, Father God. We thank you for tapping us on our shoulder this morning and telling us to arise, my daughter, arise, my son. I still have work for you to do in the land of the living. Daddy God, we ask for forgiveness this morning, Father God. Everything we may have thought, said, and done that was unpleasing in your sight, Father God. Father God, cleanse us, purge us, wash us, Father God. Create in us a clean heart, Father God. Renew a right spirit within us, Father God. Father God, we're sitting at your feet this morning, Father God. We don't want to hoop. We don't want to preach. We don't want to holler, Father God, but we want to make our requests known to you, Father God. Father God, the pandemic is traumatic, Father God. Sickness is traumatic, Father God. Father God, the loss of a loved one is traumatic, Father God. Suicide is traumatic, Father God. Father God, having loved ones in the hospital in ICU, you is traumatic, Father God. Father God, abuse is traumatic, Father God. Physical abuse, Father God. Sexual abuse, Father God. Mental abuse, Father God. Spiritual abuse, Father God. Father God, divorce is traumatic, Father God. Father God, the abandonment of a husband, Father God, is traumatic, Father God. The abandonment
of a wife, Father God, is traumatic, Father God. Father God, we have many traumatic experiences in our life, Father God, that we unfortunately had suppressed, Father God, and we did not address, Father God. Father God, we can't heal what's not revealed, Father God. So this morning, Father God, we sit at your feet, Father God, and we ask that you would deliver us this morning, Father God. Deliver us, Father God, from the traumatic experiences in our lives, Father God. Deliver us, Father God, when we had to lay our loved one to rest, Father God, in the blessed name of Jesus, Father God. But don't allow us to be ashamed, Father God, of those traumatic experiences, Father God, and think, Father God, that we're not walking by faith, Father God, if we need to sit, chill, and heal through the process, Father God, in the blessed name of Jesus, Father God. The loss of a job is traumatic, Father God. Racism is traumatic, Father God, in the blessed name of Jesus, Father God. Homelessness is traumatic, Father God. Not having any food to eat is traumatic, Father God. Not knowing how you're going to pay your bills, Father God, is traumatic, Father God. Father God, not knowing where your children are at is traumatic, Father God. Children not knowing where their parents are at is traumatic, Father God. Many of us suffer from these traumatic experiences, Father God, but we want to get up, press, and move, and move, and move, Father God, when we need to sit at your feet, Father God, chill and heal, Father God, because it is a process, Father God, in the blessed name of Jesus, Father God. Help us to walk out your process, Father God. Hold our hand as we go through the process, Father God. You said, Father God, when we are weak, you are strong, Father God. So we need you to be strong right now, Father God. Many of us are hurting, Father God. Father God, the world is hurting, Father God. We're crying out, Father God. We have a bearing wound, Father God, and we need your help, Father God, in the blessed name of Jesus, Father God. We can't do this without you, Father God. Many of us are starting new journeys, Father God, but yet we still need the process of sitting, chilling, and healing, Father God, in the blessed name of Jesus, Father God. Father God, those traumatic experiences, Father God, they create our character, Father God. They create our integrity, Father God. And we wonder why, Father God. We angry, Father God. We frustrated, Father God. Father God, deception is traumatic, Father God. Father God, narcissism is traumatic, Father God. Division is traumatic, Father God. In the blessed name of Jesus, Father God. But Father God, we look to the hills which cometh our help, Father God. And our help comes from the Lord, Father God. So I'm asking today, Father God, that you would meet us right where we're at, Father God. You know the very counts of hairs on our head, Father God. Father God, you know us through and through, Father God. Father God, we're tired of being on this emotional roller coaster, Father God. One day we're up, Father God, and the next day we're down, Father God. In the blessed name of Jesus, Father God, we don't want to have to fake a smile or fake it till we make it, Father God. In the blessed name of Jesus, we want to be delivered. We want to be set free, Father God. For who the Son sets free is free indeed, Father God. In the blessed name of Jesus, Father God. So we will take this time, Father God, and we will move at our own pace, Father God. In the blessed name of Jesus, Father God, we will definitely feel it all, Father God. We will go at our own pace, Father God. We will sleep or move mindfully, Father God, and we will definitely look for the root, Father God, as we sit, chill, and heal, for it is a process. Father God, we do thank you. We do praise you, and we do honor you, for there is no other God other than you. I have seen his ways and will heal him. I will also lead him and restore comforts to him and his mourners. We declare and we decree we will address our dramatic experiences, not
suppress them. In Jesus' precious name, we seal this prayer up. Amen, amen, and amen. Have a wonderful, blessed Monday. Love on somebody else as God has already created someone to love on you.